What's up, guys? Wade Willis here to break down episode 1063 for One Piece titled The Only Family I've Got. I'm not gonna lie, I was really expecting kind of a more chill chapter where we're exploring Egghead, and I was wrong. This was one of the craziest chapters that I've read, and that's really saying something because Oda has been going ham since we finished Wano. It's been absolute pandemonium. And this was, in my opinion, maybe the most wild, just with all the information we got. And yeah, my emotions are kind of all over the place. But yeah, let's break this down. And yeah, guys, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel for tons of anime reactions, reviews, manga reviews. I got it all here. But yeah, to start off, the cover story, we got some really important news. It looked like last chapter that it was kind of frozen over, so everyone was kind of assuming that Aokiji was maybe going to get pudding. Well, it looks like that's actually true. Pudding is missing. Looks like everything's frozen. And we know that she has that ability that Blackbeard would obviously probably find attractive. And she is probably attractive as well, so I wouldn't be surprised if Blackbeard wants to marry her too, or have her as some mistress type thing. I don't know. I would not be shocked at all with that. Life is about the simple pleasures, like seeing Luffy super fat from eating way too much. And we got to start off the chapter with that. Luffy, Chopper, and Bonnie just... they're basically as wide as they are tall. Just absolutely stuffed from eating all the food. And Jinbei, I believe, didn't really eat it all. But that didn't stop him from catching strays from Vegapunk, who basically says, like, yeah, you guys can sure eat. Look how, like, big you are. And Jinbei has to say, my belly was already like that. Then we see that Luffy has a fresh outfit. I mean, his drip is strong with his futuristic outfit. He's got some moon boots, some cool gloves. I mean, he's looking fresh. And we see that they got this fashion store where they could just change their clothes and everything. Bonnie's outfit, huge fan. She is absolutely gorgeous. Yeah, just super hot. And really cool that Jinbei takes like an tropical style chopper, picks like a futuristic kind of alien style, just like Luffy and Bonnie. I'm really loving it. I think this is pretty cool. But yeah, it seems like Bonnie's about to head off and talk to Vegapunk, but her trip is cut short as RoboCop Kuma shows up, and I mean, this outfit is kind of funny. It's the whole police thing too. It's so unnecessary, but yeah, he is literally RoboCop, this pacifista version, and he's pissed. Apparently, this food and these clothes that did not have a cashier, just let them take them. Apparently it was stealing. I mean, kind of an oversight by Vegapunk. I think it would be a lot cheaper to have a cashier or something to accept a form of payment than to spend the money to make a whole pacifista just to police this. It makes no sense. And yeah, this Kuma version is just going nuts. He's blowing stuff up. And Jinbei, like, calls it out, saying, like, this is causing way more damage than we did. Yeah, I completely agree. Although, the amount of food that Bonnie and Luffy probably ate might have been worth the whole pacifista, I'm unsure. But, yeah, definitely going overboard with the just blowing things up using his laser beams, completely unnecessary. And Luffy's ready to basically gum elephant gun him, and Bonnie comes out of nowhere, Bruce Lee cross kicks him in the chest, and tells Luffy, hey, you can't hurt him. It's her father. And Luffy's like, what the hell? Like, they're all blown away and realize, oh, the cyborg that you were talking about in the last chapter is Kuma. Bonnie, it's really heartbreaking. We see her just sobbing, and I've already really grown attached to Bonnie at this point. And Bonnie's begging them not to hurt her father. And it looks like she's about to get just straight up blown up by this pacifista, and Luffy is kind of yelling at her, saying this isn't her actual father, it's a pacifista, but it looks like he's going in to save her. And I thought at this point, wow, what a good chapter. This was kind of intense this was definitely way more intense than I was expecting. But a good chapter nevertheless. And then I realized, oh, there's more to read. And soon as I read, say, I'm like, oh shit. This is not good. And every time I see Blackbeard, I'm automatically like, my skin's on fire. I hate this guy so much. Such a well done character, because I despise this fool so much. I cannot wait until he's defeated. He is essentially like the bane of my existence at this point. He's just so terrible. I hate him. And then we see Law Submarine, and I'm like, oh no. Law's gonna be the one that has to fight Blackbeard already? Like, I thought we were gonna get some time for maybe, like, Law or Luffy to kind of, like, get even stronger before having to fight Blackbeard, because, I mean, that fool's strong as hell. And, but no. Law, and it looks like Law's submarine is has a leak in it, and he's basically calling for his crew that they need to surface. And guys, I was like, wait, why does Law have boobs? And I'm like, he kind of looks kind of hot. And then I realized, like, oh, he's turned into a girl somehow. This is strange. And apparently there's some contagion. Infection that is turning his crew into women, and I'm like, okay, this is, so someone in Blackbeard's crew has some weird gender devil fruit thing. I was like, okay, this is definitely strange. Law basically mentions, like, oh, okay, like, this is no big deal, this is devil fruit, I can just use haki to, like, reverse this. And this made me think, how many of Law's crew members can use haki? I'm pretty sure it's only Law. And then I'm like, okay, how many of Law's crewmates know or, like, have a devil fruit ability? Pretty sure it's only Law. And I'm like realizing, okay, this is probably, like, the worst person to go against Blackbeard. Like, Law's crew, it's about as strong as if me and my friends just, like, were riding on the ship along with Law. Like, just some random jabronis off the street, and you're like, hey, let's throw these guys in here. Few of my friends, like, did MMA and stuff. Like, okay, I guess that'll come in kind of handy, but we would get straight murked by Blackbeard pirates. And that's what I'm thinking going into this. And I'm like, okay, maybe there's going to be some equalizer or something. Something to help Law out here. And you know what? I was completely wrong, because then we get introduced to a bunch of Blackbeard's pirates that have brand new devil fruit abilities. So we knew there was something weird going on with the gender thing. Well, that is Doc Q doing this. He has the sick, sick fruit, and he infected them with a gender thing. And guys, I know people are going to straight up lose their minds over this, saying, oh, how is, like, changing your gender a disease? I'm not going to get into any of this, but I was like, man, Oda, he just likes to see what people are going to say with this gender thing. And I chuckled a little bit just thinking in my head, like, oh man, someone's head's literally going to explode from reading this. But nevertheless, we see that Doc Q has that ability, which, and it seems like his sick fruit, he can do different illnesses and stuff. So I don't know the parameters for, like, is it like his imagination? He can make up an illness or what? And how is it? It seems like it's transferred maybe by, okay, one person, he can kind of give it to a group of people. Once they touch someone or come into contact someone, it passes it on. We don't know exactly how it works yet, but it seems like it could be really powerful. And kind of by the way he was talking, it seems like he was kind of just messing around with them a little bit. But this, it seems like it could be an annoying ability, but with the ease that Law just kind of like yeeted it with his hockey, I don't think it's going to be the worst thing to deal with. Maybe like Zoro, Luffy, Sanji, I feel like they might be able to deal with it. Maybe even Robin. So I don't know. Some of the weaker people in the crew. Oh, Jinbei. I think a lot of the crew will be okay. I think Oda's maybe using this to like as a humor thing, and it may just be an inconvenience. But for Law's crew, it's kind of a big deal because all those people are weak as hell. And then we see Van Auger, who is the sniper of Blackbeard's crew, and he has the Warp Warp fruit. Now, this fruit is like really a extremely useful fruit. We see that he can just teleport Jesus Burgess kind of far away. Now, again, implications, like is this going to have to do with the person's sight? Can he only warp them to places that he can see? Now, this guy has like crazy vision, so it seems like he's kind of the perfect person to have this fruit. Like, you can use it even more for him than like the normal person. And I think he's probably going to have to see where he's teleporting the people. Otherwise, this is literally like pretty broken, but it seems like Oda doesn't care about how broken these Blackbeard pirates are. So he teleports. Oh, and not to mention, for a sniper to have this, he can basically see an opponent, look, go right behind them and snipe them out. Or just teleport himself right to their blind spot. This is an extremely powerful devil fruit for Van Auger. So for other people, it would just be very useful and like a practical skill. But for him, this is extremely deadly. Out of all of them that we get in this chapter from Blackbeard's pirates that we didn't know before, I feel like this is probably the scariest one, in my opinion. But yeah, he teleports Jesus Burgess, who has like a cyborg head now, it looks like, from Sabo just like crushing his head. But it looks like he has kind of like a cyborg head a little bit, or at least that's how I was looking at it. He gets teleported to this island, straight up throws a whole mountain at the Heart Pirates. And we realize he has the buff fruit. And this dude was already extremely strong. He's dumb as hell. So, I mean, for raw strength, I think this is someone we're going to see Franky end up fighting against him. And it could be like kind of an interesting battle and kind of fun. But, I mean, this dude's kind of an idiot. So, if you put someone with tactics, I think they could easily defeat him, even though this is like the perfect devil fruit for him, because he doesn't have to have any type of intelligence or strategy really to use it. It's just pure brute strength, making him even stronger at what he's already strong at. So yeah, this is really good ability for him. But then we have Law. And he has the op-op fruit, does the room, gets out of the situation. And guys, Oda's humor in this chapter was just on point. And we see Blackbeard flying up on the back of Stronger and Doc Q. Poor Stronger is fighting for its life. It looks like Stronger's dying. Doc Hughes, like, kind of telling Blackbeard, like, yo, dude, like, this is a bit much for Stronger. And we learn that Stronger has eaten the horse fruit, mythical zone, Pegasus, and can fly now, which seems like it would be a pretty OP zone devil fruit, because Pegasus is pretty awesome. And you're like, wait, why is he, like, Pegasus, like, being crushed? Yo, it's, not only is it Doc Hugh on him, which is, I mean, okay, that should be easy, but then you got Blackbeard, who's just fat. We have the whole theory of him being three people, so I don't know how dense his body is. Like, that's just a lot of weight. And I kind of do like when Oda will, like, put some, like, you're like, oh, Pegasus, like, oh, that'll be strong as hell. And then you just see it getting crushed by Blackbeard, and it kind of flips it on its head a little bit, and it's like, oh, that poor Stronger. I feel so bad for it right now. Kind of reminded me a bit of Frankie just running over Big Mom's face, and still one of my favorite moments in One Piece period. And I was kind of surprised about the thing that Blackbeard starts asking a lot about. He brings up the pony glyphs, assuming, like, hey, Kaido must have had one. You have some pony glyph rubs. Like, I want them. So I was surprised by this because we hadn't gotten any clues that Blackbeard had wanted the anything to do with the pony glyphs. And that's probably just ignorance by me. Like, he's really swiping up anything that can give him, like, knowledge or strength. So, I mean, it really isn't that shocking. But, yeah, I mean, him and Law basically challenge each other. Winner takes all. So, maybe Blackbeard has, like, none of the pony glyphs. Maybe he has Big Mom's now, since it looks like Aokiji, like, abducted Pudding. Maybe he went over there, took a rub of the pony glyph too. Maybe he has the one that's missing for Luffy. I'm guessing it might be that, or he could just have none of them and was, like, lying to Law. Or, I mean, it doesn't matter if Law gets straight up murked. It doesn't, he's going to have to give him the stuff. But, yeah, Law's, I love Law's confidence here, but, I mean, Law has probably one of the strongest devil fruit abilities, but Blackbeard has two of the strongest devil fruit abilities, plus the most, a really OP crew. Because even, like, some of the Jabronis in the crew now have freaking strong devil fruit abilities. His crew can get just destroyed in essentially an instant. Law's going to have to protect his crew. I don't think we're going to really see this fight on screen or in the chapter. I hope we do, but, I mean, Law's one of my favorite characters. I don't think he's going to be killed off here, but I also wouldn't be shocked. We're in the final arc. Oda's, like, going at a speed I'm absolutely shocked by. So let's think about it. So Blackbeard he's about to have Law imprisoned, in my opinion, and his whole crew. He has Pudding. Okay, that's very valuable for the pony glyphs. And then he also has Kobe. Things are about to get wild. He has a lot of things that Luffy cares about. Well, I mean, Luffy doesn't really care about Pudding, but I think Sanji kind of still does care for her in a weird way, even though she was going to kill him, but then she started to change. I could see Sanji really wanting to help her still. But Kobe and Law, that's like, those are two people that Luffy and the crew really care about. So yeah, I think that's gonna be crazy. But I think Blackbeard's gonna straight up, like, murk his whole crew, and then we're gonna have to deal with all the cipher pole stuff with Luffy before we even, like, start to even think about this. But, yeah, looking at the abilities that Blackbeard's, like, even, like, lower on the totem pole people have, guys, this is crazy. I think we are about to have another kind of power-up for Luffy's crew. They're going to really need one, and I think it's going to be compliments of Vegapunk. They're going to need it just to get through this stuff on Egghead, probably, with all of these people coming over. But, things are not looking good for the Heart Pirates and Luffy's crew with how freaking leveled up Blackbeard's pirates are. I guess I could also see, and I'm gonna do probably a theory video later, but I could see, I think seeing Shanks's crew go up against Blackbeard's would be very interesting, just because Shanks's crew is literally the polar opposite, where no one has devil fruit abilities, it's all just Haki. So I think they would be like a pretty decent match for Blackbeard, but Blackbeard has obviously his underhand tactics. But at this point, I think Luffy's going to need to do another team up, and it's going to have to be with Shanks to take out Blackbeard, because that is frightening right now. Especially somehow he has freaking Aokiji on his side too, and I still don't get that. But I digress. Crazy chapter though, guys. Let me know what you thought in the comments below.